You've been flagging for a while now that the CDC has lagged far behind many other data inputs.
Yeah, if we analyze the CDC, our preeminent healthcare institution, as a university, then its actions throughout its history make sense. But if we analyze the CDC as our country and, I'd argue, the world's public health response agency, it has sadly fallen very short. And one of the issues is data. But this, the bigger issue has to do, in my opinion, with its culture. Now, don't get me wrong here. The CDC is filled with dedicated public health servants committed to a public health mission. But the culture has done our country a big disservice.
Talk us through that. Like, how can the culture be different?
You know, there's a couple of different problems. I'm going to highlight two. The CDC would rather wait and wait and wait for data than be fast. And that's a huge problem in the midst of a pandemic. Just to be clear, we're in the midst of a pandemic. Response is critical. If you look at CDC's history, sometimes the data they report can be years old. In the middle of a pandemic, days count and weeks certainly count. And the second problem, I think, is a bigger one. And that is that the CDC would rather reinvent the wheel themselves than leverage innovation or ideas that are built anywhere else. Now, we've seen this time and again. At the very beginning of the pandemic, we saw that CDC had to rebuild its own diagnostic tests, despite the fact that other countries, the WHO, already had diagnostic tests going out. And unfortunately, those tests didn't work, and that caused a big delay. In my experience with the CDC, I've learned that they just don't have a willingness to engage with private businesses. And that's a big problem. You know, there's innovation, there's digital health innovations, there's diagnostic innovations and vaccine innovations going on in the private sector. And the CDC, in my opinion, should be playing that sort of central coordinating role. And that's a big challenge. If you're not willing to be the response agency in that coordinating role in the midst of a pandemic, that's a problem.
Why is that? Because, you know, previous directors of the CDC have said there's been a lack of investment, but you would have thought outsourcing to private companies would do away with some of the sheer scale of money they need to deploy themselves.
You know, recently I was in my highest, most senior level conversation with CDC officials. And I said to them, hey, listen, we've been building this early warning system for a decade now. We saw the pandemic. We saw this unusual spread of illness in March of 2020. Weeks before case count surge, as early as 2017, we called the worst flu season on record months before you, is now the time to partner. We've been trying to reach out to them. And their response to me was, we don't really work with technology startups and private companies. That's the CDC Foundation's role. And I thought to myself, you're kidding me. You're kidding. At this moment in time, we're in a pandemic. You're not willing to partner with private companies. So I went and did my homework afterwards. I talked to other companies who were in a similar position. There's a lot of money flowing through the American Rescue Plan for things like genomic sequencing. So I called some of the genomic sequencing company up. And the same thing is happening there. This unwillingness to use innovation or partner with other sectors is not something that's new to the CDC. This is decades in the making. And if you look at what the CDC did, please, sorry.
Well, no, I'm just interested as to whether other countries are doing it better. You can compare and contrast so many different countries in different ways. And I mean, look at the numbers of people with COVID in the UK. It's not exactly a standout. But what is happening very well is they're measuring, they're taking data, people are testing, there's availability of tests at least. Whereas in the US, I see the queues going around for miles and an inability to get some of those lateral flows until out to January. So, but is the NHS partnering with startups, or are other countries doing it better?
I think the other countries are playing, have different levels of success. The UK's NHS is a central coordinating body. It's coordinating amongst private entities, amongst health systems. It's really playing that central role. And that's the role that I want CDC to play here in the United States. I think it's really, really important that we equip the Centers for Disease Control to be a response agency, which is written into its mandate.
It's sort of fascinating that it hasn't been, and a great underserving, I'm sure, to the United States population. Are you hopeful, having had those senior conversations? Is it still like, no, can't, this is not part of who we are, and will something have to be born in and of itself anew? Or do you think that they will have lessons learned?
You know, I hope that they will have lessons learned. But again, if I talk to my advisors, if I talk to ex-government officials who've worked with the CDC, I find that this trend continues time and again. And it is, you know, an unfortunate situation that the CDC doesn't necessarily play well with other government agencies. If we look at the agencies that actually partnered with the private sector during the pandemic, that was HHS, it was the Department of Defense that led those efforts, not CDC. And so my hope is that there's an opportunity for this pandemic to result in a big shift in culture. But if I'm being honest with myself, you know, that's a tough one if it's decades entrenched. And it might need Congress to set up a parallel entity to really be the response vehicle while CDC continues to be the research vehicle.